Hello friends, today's topic is varieties of human speech. So language is not homogeneous. The way I speak or I use language is entirely different from the way you speak or you use the language. That means there are a network of varieties for a same language. It is said that there are about 6 varieties or 6 kinds of varieties based on region, education, social setting, subject matter, medium, attitude, indifference, etc. So let's discuss what are these language varieties. So first variety is register. Language varies according to a person. First one is register. Language variety, which is typical of certain discipline or occupation or social roles, is called register. For example, I'm a teacher. While I speak with my fellow teachers, I use some terms which is only understandable by a teacher. For example, entry activity or prerequisites or rapport, like that. At the same time, there is doctor's register. That is, a doctor, while speaking with his fellow doctors or colleagues, he used some terms which is only understandable by a person of that profession. And this terms is not used by him while he is speaking with his wife or his children or his friends. Okay. That is, a person is using certain set of words in a language which is understandable to the person of his profession only. Such a language is called register. Next one is jargon. A set of words or expressions used by a specific group is called jargon. For example, there is teacher's jargon or advocate's jargon. As I mentioned in register, there are some terms which a teacher usually use while speaking with his fellow teachers. For example, rapport, entry activity, prerequisites. What is the correct meaning is not understandable by another person out of this profession. Okay, that is what jargon, a set of words or expressions. Next important topic is dialect. Dialect is a language variety used by a particular group of individuals which differ in grammar, vocabulary, and pronunciation. For example, there are national varieties of English, as we all know, like American English, Canadian English, Australian English, etc. These are all varieties of English, but it differ in pronunciation, vocabulary, grammar, etc. For example, the word color, C-O-L-O-U-R, is the correct spelling of the word color. But when it comes to American English, then its spelling is C-O-L-O-R. That is what a dialect. There are different types of dialects. First one is regional dialect. Language spoken in a particular region or particular geographical area is called regional dialect. For example, Khadi Boli is a type of Hindi which is used in Haryana, Delhi, western parts of Uttar Pradesh, etc. Next is social dialect. Dialect based on social stratification is called social dialect or sociolect. For example, in Shaw's Pygmalion, there is a flower girl. Her name is Eliza. She used Cockney dialect. And this dialect is used by low-class people living in London. That is sociolect. That is a particular language variety according to our social class. Next is standard dialect. Of course, the social prestige of the speakers of a particular highly educated region is transferred to the dialect. Such a dialect is called standard dialect. In other words, standard dialect is a variety of a language which is spoken by a group of people who are politically, socially, and economically powerful. Slang. Slang is the use of a language in an extremely informal way. Pidgin and Creole. When two mutually unintelligible speech communities who do not share a common language come in contact, they need a language. At that time, they created a type of language in order to communicate each other. Such languages are called Pidgin languages. And when this Pidgin languages turn into mother tongue of a speech community, it is called Creole. For example, at the time of colonization in India, a Pidgin English was spoken between the British and the natives, such as Butler English of Madras, Pidgin English of Bombay, like that. Bilingualism or multilingualism. When people belonging to different cultural and linguistic background happen to live together, they began to study the language of that particular geographical area. This is called bilingualism or multilingualism. For example, when people of India, they began to settle in another foreign country or like that, they began to learn the language of that place. If there are one more languages, they began to learn that languages too. Okay, that is called bilingualism. The word bi means two and multi means more than two. So bilingualism means a person who is well versed in two languages. Multilingualism means a person who is well versed with two or more languages. We are all multilinguals. Why? Because we know our regional language, then whether it is Tamil or Kannada or Telugu or Malayalam or Hindi. Then we know English, then also Hindi. Okay, so we are all multilinguals. Code switching or code mixing. It is quite common that while speaking, we use English words with our mother tongue. That is what code mixing or code switching. That is, a multilingual or a bilingual person switching or mixing one language to another in his usual conversation. Diglossia. The term diglossia refers to a situation where a speech community uses two varieties of a same language for different functions. These varieties include high variety and low variety. High variety is normally used in formal situations such as university lectures, in sermons in the church, like that. Then lower variety we use in conversation with our friends, families, relatives, like that.